player laying motionless on the ground, the country, perhaps some praying, others guarded, holding their breath, hopeful that this young man would survive. We'll tell you what's going on here. It happened last night. The NFL game suspended after player Damar Hamlin collapsed on the field there following a play. Let's show you fan video of exactly what happened, the aftermath, people reacting to it.
CPR.
Here's what else you need to know. Hamlin received CPR right on the field. It went on for several minutes. He was placed eventually on a stretcher, eventually into an ambulance. He was given oxygen, we learned, upon entering that ambulance, which transported him and some family members to the hospital. Hamlin was just 24 years old. He suffered a cardiac arrest following a play with his heartbeat restored on the field. According to the team, he is now sedated. He's listed in critical condition. Now, the incident inspired, if you will, some to don their worst behavior yet again. Right wingers online began speculating as if with this young man's life hanging in the balance, this was the thing to do. The cause of the medical emergency, they speculated, was due to the COVID vaccine. You see? Right there, Charlie Kirk, Joey Gilbert, Brent Stinchfield, Kevin Sorbo. This is a tragic and all too familiar sight right now. Athletes dropping suddenly. There have been too many recent died suddenly cases to deny it anymore. This is not normal. Again, Hamlin, not dead. Critical condition. The world, fans, family waiting to learn his fate. And this is what these right wingers decided to do. And so Jessica, I'd ask you to react to that first. I don't even know where your mind goes or how you come up with this drop of a dime, but indeed they did yet again.
Yeah, this is something that we saw a handful of folks talking about when it came to NBA games, doing sideline interviews. I think Sideline Sanity had an interview where they briefly touched upon, you know, athletes dropping dead because of the vaccines. So this was something that they were talking about. Now, this is just something that happens to athletes. I have a friend, I played college lacrosse. I have a friend who dropped dead on the field years before COVID. This is something that happens. And in the NFL, when you're sustaining substantive injuries, people tackling you to the ground, hitting you in the chest, you falling to the ground, getting the wind knocked out of you, this is something that can happen. We don't know. There is no scientific evidence that points to the vaccines causing this. There is scientific evidence that shows that COVID can cause cardiac arrest and blood clots. So when you consider those options, when you're deciding whether or not to get vaccinated, I mean, the choice should be to get vaccinated. The right spreading misinformation is putting people at risk at the end of the day.
Yeah, and I think you put it very intelligently, very succinctly. None of the people who tweeted this nonsense is a doctor, I don't believe. Could be wrong, correct me if I'm wrong. But that was not really even their purpose. They just wanted to get out misinformation and muddy the waters. Again, a 24-year-old young man, his family in the stands accompanying him in an ambulance, not knowing his fate. And this is what they decided to do. Also, while his fate was hanging in the balance, you had FS1 host Skip Bayless, who, if you're a sports fan, a lot of people know his work. A lot of people know his record. He strives to be opinionated and controversial somewhat. So here's what Skip was up to. He had, well, a different tasteless take on the matter, implying the game should not have been stopped. So again, this young man collapses. The players, understandably freaking out. Some of them immediately start praying, crying, everybody holding their breath. So Skip says, hey, no doubt the NFL is considering postponing the rest of this game, but how? This late in the season, a game of this magnitude is crucial to the regular season outcome, which suddenly seems so irrelevant. Really, Skip? Okay. Immediately there's backlash for that. And Skip Bayless did sort of kind of try to moonwalk it back. So then he throws up this tweet, let's put it up there. Nothing, he says, is more important than the young man's health. Well, not long before this, it was not that important to you, Skip. That was the point of my last tweet. I'm sorry if that was misunderstood, but his health is all that matters. Again, everything else is irrelevant. I prayed for him and will continue to. I mean, this is how you pray. I don't know. I don't know what more we need from you, Skip. Bayless did not acknowledge the tweet at the beginning of Tuesday's Undisputed. That's his hit show. He appeared emotional, though, about the incident. His co-host, though, Shannon Sharp, did not appear on the show. Some online now speculating it was in protest to Bayless's comment. Okay, and I'll ask you to react again, Jessica, because sure, and this time of year, right? Because you got the run up to the Super Bowl, the playoffs, everything is on the line here. Shouldn't it be instant, though, that you move beyond sports and into, I don't know, the human arena when something like this is going down? How can they postpone the game? How will they make it up? It's so late in the season. There's really no way, in my view, of getting around it. Perhaps you have a different take.
Yeah, I mean, the dynamics here are quite troubling, and there's a racial component as well. I mean, when you have sports like the NFL and NBA, when you have players that are majority black, majority people of color, doing the hard labor, putting their bodies on the line for the entertainment of others, and so that the owners who are majority white can make a profit. I mean, there's clear racial components to this. And for the fans, it's like, why don't you get out there and play the game for all of us? I don't care that you're scared right now, that your friend could lose his life, is in critical condition. You know, I don't care that you're in this state and we're asking you to go out there and play a game and now put your body on the line knowing the possible consequences, as has just been demonstrated. I mean, it's a lot to ask of someone, but you're putting your entertainment above literally their lives. Like that's the dynamics here, and it's that serious. And if you're, you know, the NFL, or if you're ESPN or a streaming network, it's so obvious that the motive there is profit, so that they can continue to get their viewers, their advertisers can continue to advertise on the game stream, so that all of the sponsorships, you know, get their money from the game. There's so many dollars on the line, and that is so clearly the priority, especially when you see the replay of what happened, of him collapsing on the field from every possible angle. And when we cover the story, we have to use a fan video because there's so much copyright protections on that stream. It's so obvious that the game has been adapted in every possible way to make it as profitable as possible. And now I think it's time for them to make it as safe as possible for the players as well.
Yeah, I think you're spot on. And there seems to be a lot of collusion. I was monitoring things this morning and I noticed there was a lot of comment from some of the regulars, some of the famed NFL reporters. And of course, you can't be that unless you're kind of sharing a bed with the NFL because they won't allow it. They'll run you out of there, okay? They'll run you out of there. And they seem to all be quick to say, hey, my reporting, the NFL at no time discussed continuing with this game. My reporting shows the NFL played it just right. Since when has the NFL played it just right? Really? Really? Okay. And you know, you make a strong point too about the racial component. And I'll say this, all these other players on the field, you're right. You know, it's like shut up and dribble, or in this case, shut up and play football. Do you think they want to go on? They don't even know what happened here. They don't know if their teammate, their friend, their colleague is going to survive. But no matter that, Skip, no matter. Not everyone embodied a trash box behavior during this critical moment. There were plenty of people, while Hamlin is still hospitalized, who said, what can we do to help? And they decided to donate. And they did it again and again and again, millions to his toy drive, the Chasing M's Foundation Community Toy Drive. It's up to an incredible, okay, his goal was 2,500, you see it there. It's up to an incredible $4,105,560, okay? Like we said, not everybody wants to be trashy. Some people say, you know what, I feel helpless, I am wanting this young man to survive desperately, be whole again, his family to be okay. What can I do? Okay, I'll donate. I'll do something, I'll donate. That's what they did.